Hey there. So let me walk you through this little demo of a DIY project I got going. It's not meant to be a tutorial, just a demo. So let's go take a look. So that's the solar panel I have. It's a 25 watt Echo Flow. I paid about $32 on Amazon. And here's my charge controller. It's a PWM 20 amp charge controller. It's one of the cheapest out there. So I'm not expecting any kind of reliability out of it. I did look at MPPTs, they are bulkier and they are more expensive, so I went with this. 20 amps is enough because I have a 25 watt solar panel and I have a 12 volt battery. 25 divided by 12, that's about 2 amps. 20 amps is plenty. And here's the battery we'll be using. It's a 12 volt 8 amp hour battery. I had this battery lying around for a while, and I don't think it's going to hold charge quite a bit, but we'll try it out, see how it does. The wires, they're 18 gauge. I do not have a fuse here. That's not a great thing. There should really be a fuse on there. There's always a fire risk when working with batteries. Quick segue there. If you're working with batteries and if you are not aware of all the risks, you really need to read up on those. These can be really dangerous. So I'm going to use these as well as part of my project, the inverter and the cigarette lighter adapter. Don't really need to have an adapter, but makes it convenient. Okay, let's see how things are looking here. We got everything connected. We got the controller right here connected to the batteries. We got the controller connected to the solar panels through these wires going out all the way outside. And we got the load terminal connected to our cigarette lighter adapter. No load connected right now. We'll try that later. But let's take a look at the LCD screen. There you go. That shows 12.8 volts current battery charge. And the arrow flashing between the solar panel and the batteries showing that a charge is in progress. If you want to activate the load, here's a button that says load is activated and we can connect something there, but we're not going to try that now. We're going to let this go on for a while. I would like it to charge to my float voltage of 13.5 volts. And once we get there, I want to try out a few things using the load terminal and see how that goes. All right, let's give it a bit and come back. We're back here. Sun is shining pretty good. Looking at the controller, we are at about 13.5, 13.7 volts. My first test. I am going to connect my phone. Let's look for some USB charging here. Okay, now as soon as I connected that, you saw it dropped a bit to about 13.3. It's no longer going to 13.7. The sun is still out the same. It's not cloudy, but you can see a small voltage drop, not a whole lot. All right, I've hooked up a fan here to the cigarette lighter adapter right there, and this is a car fan. The load is still off, so nothing's running, but here's, now it's time to activate it and let's see what happens. There we go, fan's running. You have the LED on here as well, showing that power is flowing. And I want you to take a look at the voltage here. It dropped from 13.5 to about 13.1 or 13.2, kind of expected. Even though the sun is all out, I was expecting a little drop in voltage, but that's not a whole lot. I'm pretty happy about that, which means even with a little bit of cloudy weather, this fan will work great. And if your battery is good, you'll get a good amount of use of the fan after the sun goes down. So that's looking pretty good. Let's turn that off. And the next step will be to plug in an inverter and try some AC loads. So let's go try that. The load I want to try is this AC fan. It's about a 28 watt fan, divide by 12 volts. I get 2.3 amperes, so give or take. So with 2.3 amps, that's not a huge amount of current. These wires are fine for that. However, I did not want that kind of current flowing through the controller, so I wired it differently. I wired my load straight to the battery as opposed to the load terminal of the controller. Now 2.3 amps should not be a concern for this controller. However,
there's something called spike current. When the motor starts here, it's going to draw more current than its usual running current. So it's going to be, it can go as 10 times as much, and that can damage damage my controller here. So hence my wiring that goes straight to the battery. And that's typically seems to be a recommended way. Whenever you use an inverter, always go directly to the battery. So connecting the inverter first. There you go. You can hear the inverter fan coming on. Awesome. However, it was 13.5, it just went to like 13.2. Still going up to 13.5, not bad. Next step, let's plug our fan in. There we go. All right, fan is on, it's oscillating. Now I got the fan at the highest setting now, highest speed and oscillation on. That's why you see that drop from 13.4 or 13.2 to 12.8. So let me try reducing the speed there and see if that helps. I'll turn the oscillation off and speed as well to 1, which is a lower speed. Let's see how that does. I don't know if it's helping a whole lot. So, yeah, I would just keep it at the higher speed, the way it's working. So, there we go. All right. So, that's not bad at all. So, it's been about 5 minutes or so with the fan running, and I can see the voltage going between 12.4 and 12.7, mostly staying around 12.6, 12.5. Which is not bad. It's doing pretty good. I was expecting, because of the health of my battery, that things may drop a little further, but I'm happy so far. That was fun. Thanks for watching. Few takeaways. I would probably use a better charge controller, a brand name one, or even an MPPT, just for reliability, mainly. Another thing, I would use lithium batteries if I didn't have one lying around already. And maybe I'm going to try that and do another video about it. Meanwhile, please leave some feedback and please subscribe. Thanks.